Good morning. I am here to deal with natural resources and how they are being classified. Yes. So what are natural resources? And you can see that these resources can be classified into different types. So how these are being classified? So you can classify basically into human resources and natural resources. So last class we have dealt with based upon their origin, based upon their utility, and based upon their continual utility, we can classify the resources. So first, based upon their origin. Based upon their origin, you can classify it into abiotic and biotic resources. Abiotic resources means what? They are inorganic. For example, land, water, air, minerals, all these comes under inorganic. So they are called as abiotic resources or non-living inorganic matter. Okay. Now we are moving to biotic resources. Biotic resources are also called as organic living molecules and their products. Organic living molecules. Okay. Organic molecules means what? They are living. It can be what all things? Forest, forest products, crops, birds, animal, fishes and other marine organisms. So I know you understand what is on based upon their origin, you can classify it into abiotic and biotic. Okay, abiotic and biotic. Now we will move it based upon their utility. So how they are classified based upon their utility. So you know we are using materials or resources as food, as raw materials and as source of energy. Okay. So we all know there are various types of natural resources. Based upon their utility we are being considering it as resource. Soil, climate, flora and fauna of India, even forest, fish we are using, land we are using, water, wildlife, energy resources, all these comes under based on utility. Okay. But based on continual utility, we can classify it into renewable and non-renewable resources. Okay. So based upon continual utility. So now you have another classification that is based upon abundance. It can be inexhaustible, exhaustible and intangible. Okay. So what is inexhaustible? That is non-depletable. Non-depletable. Just like our renewable resources. What about exhaustible? They are depleted. They are being gone. Just like fossil fuels, petroleum products. Okay, intangible. So it comes under both non-depleted and depleted ones. Intangible. Okay. So we'll discuss more about it. So natural resources, as I told you, you can classify it into inexhaustible, exhaustible and intangible. So inexhaustible can be again classified into cosmic resources. What is cosmic? Solar energy, gravity of sun and moon. Okay. And climatic resources, which are the abiotic factors, right? Climatic resources. So cosmic resources and climatic resources. Okay. And cosmic resources is solar energy and gravity, both in sun and moon. Okay. And what about climatic resources? It is air, wind, tidal power and even our rainfall. So all these comes under climatic resources. Now we are moving with exhaustible resources. Exhaustible resources, that is based upon the utility, based upon the usage, okay, utility we are saying. Based upon the utility, you can classify this thing into exhaustible resources can be classified into renewable resources and non-renewable resources. These terms are very familiar from lower classes we are learning, right? So that is renewable resources and non-renewable resources. Renewable resources means what? Renewable resources can be renewed. Okay, after their exploitation, it is always available for our use. Okay, but what about a non-renewable? If you are going to exploit it, it cannot be used because it is depleted fast. Okay, now you understand what is depleted and non-depleted. So renewable resources are non-depleted and non-renewable are depleted because we are exploiting it, but we won't be able to get it very fast. But renewable resources, we are exploiting it, but we will get it faster. Okay, so in that, renewable resources can be classified into different types. Okay, that is edaphic. What is edaphic? Edaphic means soil. Okay, soil. Edaphic means soil resources. Water, you know, water resources and bioresources, both flora and fauna. Okay, biological species, flora, fauna, anything can come under renewable resources. Now we are moving to non-renewable resources. What are the non? I've already told, fossil fuels, burning of coal, mineral deposits like gold, zinc, aluminium. We are digging it, right? Now biological species, some endangered species, we are using it. For example, rhinoceros, tiger, lion, all these comes under biological species. If you are utilizing it continuously, those endangered enlisted species, it comes under non-renewable energy. So this is how we are going to understand the classification of, and next is the intangible. Intangible comes under both, we'll discuss it later. Okay, so these are the renewable resources and non-renewable resources under exhaustible heading. Inexhaustible heading, you can see cosmic resources and climatic resources. Okay, so these are the classification of how we are going to classify natural resources. So one more time I'm saying, based upon their origin, based upon their utility, based upon their continuous utility, that is exhaustible and inexhaustible, that is also coming under based upon their availability or abundance. Okay, hope you got it. So let me put a tick. Based upon origin, based upon utility, and based upon abundance or continual utility. Okay, so this is the way, and we have detailed description of inexhaustible, exhaustible, and intangible. Okay, intangible, and we will deal it in the next class. So this is inexhaustible is cosmic resource, climatic resource. Exhaustible is renewable and non-renewable. Okay, so these are the understanding of today's class. On next class, we will move with detailed sections.